At the time of the battle, the property we're on now was known as McPherson's Farm. If you look over your left shoulder, behind us, you can see McPherson's Barn, all that remains of McPherson's Farm buildings. Still looking over to our left, you can see Seminary Ridge and Old Dorm, the building with the green cupola on it. Now, let's look over to the fields on our right. We're now looking in the direction where most of the Confederate lost of contact with his cavalry. What happened was that during their northward march, a great portion of his cavalry had gone further north towards Washington. As a Confederate cavalry commander, it was one of Jeb Stuart's functions to act as eyes and ears of Lee's army. But by advancing his men around Washington, he allowed Union troops to come between himself and Lee. As a result, at the end of June, Lee was pretty much in the dark about his enemy's whereabouts and of communications. And when the first Confederate skirmishers started to advance towards Gettysburg the next morning, Union cavalry was waiting for them. By 8 o'clock that morning, the two armies collided, and the Battle of Gettysburg was underway. For the first hour, the Union's fighting cavalrymen put up a strong fight and held their ground. But one was planned, and an excavation had been cut out for it. Right after we cross over Route 30 again, we'll be driving over the railroad cut. It was the scene of one of the South's most embarrassing setbacks of the first day's fighting. When they drove the Northern soldiers out, they made the mistake of getting into the railroad cut.
This is the peace line, and
it's dedicated to the memory of both the Northern and Confederate soldiers who died at the Battle of Gettysburg and throughout the war. This is a real nice place to come visit, except it's raining today.
A tough seasoned veteran and another North Carolinian proudly carried the flag of his state. The state of North Carolina suffered huge losses at Gettysburg. About one of every four Confederate casualties here was a North Carolinian, discharging every responsibility with the same dignity, skill, and gentlemanliness that earned him his exceptional reputation. Then in 1861, when Virginia seceded from the Union, General Robert E. Lee was faced with one of the most difficult decisions of his personal life. Personally obnoxious, Robert E. Lee chose to stand by the land of his birth. In 1861, he resigned his birth to unthinkable heights. General Lee was imaginative.
Good morning.
Good morning.
What day is it? It's Good Friday.
And here we are at Washington, PA,
we're at the Bartusik's. Finally, it's a pretty place. Okay, we'll see some more in a little bit, but I'll just pan down here. What are you doing, John? Talk to me. Getting ready for Good Friday services here. Peter, Kashka, and Sophie. We'll have Mary and Steffi in a minute. She's just telling about all her aches and pains, isn't she?
Pains. Even I.
She thinks you think she's as old as I am.
I know. All these nieces and nephews are getting old.
She's texting you, though.
I'm going to be looking into my bifocals because my magnifiers just aren't working very good.
Got to get her some glasses. She's blind, you know.
And almost everybody's got bifocals now. Only Mike. But he's going to. I said, you're going to. He says, oh, I'm the youngest. I said, don't even start bragging.
I can't get shit pretty good. I wear glasses,
really?
But
you can see pretty good, huh?
Yeah, I can see pretty good,
sure,
except close
good.
With.
Mm-hmm.
I can't see yet. It's not real clear.
Okay, let's see. We got.
Okay, who's gonna be the
Steffi gets to navigate.
You know how to navigate to get there? Or does somebody else know how to drive there? Mary. Okay, Mary can
just a minute.
Okay, she's
where do I
check.
Sit?
The middle one.
Washington, Pennsylvania. 1998 Easter. You exploring the farm? Hi, John. Mail pouch tobacco. Something we all should chew. The landmark across the road from the Bartusik homestead. So when you come here, you look for the mail pouch chew. You like mail pouch tobacco, John?
What?
You like that mail pouch tobacco?
I don't know what you're talking about. Oh! It's a nice house.
Nice house, huh? You enjoying your vacation, Jenny?
Yeah.
Look at me. What do you got there?
Flower.
Dandelion?
I don't know what it is.
There's a cow. Out back in the pasture. Garage and the barn. Denny and John getting into trouble. Nice breeze, very cool. Very clear and crisp today. Little outbuildings need a little repair. The ants tell us they're going to replace those probably this year. Some of them are about to fall down. I wouldn't get too close to them.
Thank you. less than 2 minutes longer, buddy. Perhaps maybe, you know what, maybe a little bit
where the tree line is.
We do have a fence here, but that's just to keep the animals segregated from the farming area and the animal area. So somebody's gonna do a foot race here in a minute. Zoom in. John is so articulate. Now, watch your step. Don't step. Don't step in anything. That's okay. Just go. Off into the sunset. Or that'd be where the sun rises, but over the hill. Go. Casualty in the course. Is he dead? Say, come on. What are you going to say? Are you turned it off?
What day is it?
Does it say
Sunday. Easter Sunday.
Does it say REC up there in the corner?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
10 after 2.
Where are we at? Where is this?
Worship, PA. Jefferson Avenue.
On the farm.
What year?
1998. April the... Twelfth.
And John's the cameraman.
Let go.
Who's coming here?
Let me focus. Hi. You can't see it, Dad.
He's here?
Where is she? Let me move it.
Don't move so fast. Okay, time out a minute. Okay, Sophie, are they about ready down there? We're about to have the great Easter egg hunt.
Remember where you put everything.
Yeah, the Easter egg marshals are out spotting. There's the head bunny.
Peter Wabbit.
Peter Wabbit. Oh, that was very good. Is that the... Very good, Danny.
He picked up some over here.
May or not.
John, did... Okay,
we'll start in a minute.
And the game is canceled.
close to going to find your egg. I'm about to tell you when you're hot or cold. If you're hot, you're close to it. If you're cold, you're way, way from
so
it.
So you start walking in the direction.
Start
she
walking.
Says hot, you're going in the right direction.
Getting warm.
Where?
You're getting warm.
But I'm
not
cold.
Hot.
Not
you're
here.
Now you're getting cold. Warmer?
No, it's not in your mouth.
You better look around.
It's pretty warm, but you better look around.
It's on the ground.
It's not on the ground.
You're
on the ground.
Step in, Kirk.
I found it.
Okay.
Now you're supposed to go to your dad.
10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh.
Well, he's a bunny, all right.
Jingle bell, jingle bell.
All the way.
Oh, my fun, Mr. Horse open sleigh. Now, can tap it.
You can pretend. Come on, you're a good imagination. Jingle bells, come on, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Yeah, river dance.
Oh, what fun it is.
He sound like tap dancer.
Your left pocket?
Oh, what pocket? Right or left?
There's nothing in there. Oh.
Ah, there was a pie egg in there, huh?
Oh, so you got both.
Now what? Now it goes to Peter. Peter?
Okay. Tell a joke.
What was that?
How do you know where a worm's mouth is?
Anything?
Which mouth is?
Where a worm's
a
mouth
worm's
is?
Mouth.
I don't know how.
Tickle him in the middle and see which side laughs.
That was a good job.
Now
that's pretty cute.
They fly like a bird.
Oh.
You were doing that before.
That's hard. That's hard.
Yeah, we're making
remember
you work
you
for every
you
egg you
on,
get here.
You fell down
work.
The hill when you were running down, you flipped.
So just wing the arms. You can run and fly. Run and fly.
That's it.
Oh, get those wings.
Then he hits the catapult.
That's
well,
right.
You better start with the oldest. Two older boys.
I forgot their name.
Oh.
I'm going to tell them.
You don't get the prize if you don't get
the big one. Who's the big one?
They're never sitting in your presence.
They play baseball and football.
Christopher.
Oh, yeah.
And who else? M.
Matt.
All right.
Now what?
Did he say?
Now do the hula.
Yep.
Hula?
Do the hula.
Oh, I really like that.
Make him keep going. I like that. I got this on film.
Go to Dan.
What?
I know.
Go do the Margarita.
Don't do
go forward. You go back. You go pull back.
Go.
Count.
Okay, get started.
One,
okay.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Another 15.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Soup.
Soup who?
Soup who? Superman.
Superman.
We wanted a funny...
Margarina. Unos, dos, tres, margarina. Unos,
okay,
dos, tres. Okay. Who was the fourth president of the United States?
Ooh, toppy.
Do you even know the answer?
Well, I think it's that. I could have said the third, but I knew the third was Adams.
Yeah, but George Washington, John
yeah, the third
Adams,
was
Thomas Jefferson, John Quincy Adams, isn't it? No, Alexander Hamilton. No,
Hamilton was never president.
George Quincy Adams.
Now we're really confused. Yeah. Okay, that's your answer.
Sophie, you failed that politics, didn't you?
You
it's U.S. history.
He was Secretary of the Treasury, wasn't he?
Yeah.
George Washington.
Mom, can I do it? Can I help
What's
you?
His third question?
That was it. Well, it's margarina. That was my question.
Alexander Hamilton.
Joking. That's
great. But yeah, that was a bad joke, though. You got any better jokes?
Yeah, come on.
That was a real lousy one.
Who's in the door?
Here, can I help him?
Who's in the door? D-U-A-L.
Well, we're wasting film here, buddy.
I got one.
That's
it's gotta be clean, John.
That's gross joke.
I know.
Come on, I'm running out of film.
Okay,
hurry up.
Film.
Hurry up.
Okay.
If you're getting a flash, hurry up.
Okay. Why did the bunny cross the road?
The bunny crossed the road, we don't know why.
That's because he's trying to get his Easter egg.
Oh, good.
Oh, I got one. They just remembered.
Oh, we're done with the jokes.
Boo-hoo.
Okay, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Boo.
Boo-hoo.
You don't need to cry about it.
Okay, that's better. Okay, Dave.
No.
Okay, tell us a joke. You should have been thinking of this. Okay, no.
That's a joke.
I got a one for him.
Okay. That was a good laugh.
Same one I did. Why? It was a good one.
No, we don't want to hear it. Say
okay.
Yeah.
Tip me over and pour me out.
Okay, who was,
a history teacher.
Name two presidents that were assassinated.
Abraham Lincoln and JFK.
Okay.
He needs a joke. Come here, Danny, we'll give you the joke.
Wait, what?
That's funny.
That was good, that was good. Quick, Danny, come on, get up here, you're on.
Because he wanted to get away from the foul smell.
Get away from the foul smell.
Oh, see, somebody laughed.
I shrugged.
Okay, I need a third one, or was that the third one?
That was his third one.
Okay.
Boy, we're pretty bad around here.
I know, man. What's happening, guys?
You got me just a joke.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana who?
Knock, knock.
Who's there? Banana who?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?